a funky southern for a dirt track. He had mud caked on his goggles and a screaming 350 sack up on his back. He heard somebody shout, "Sand on it. Come on, boss, sand on it." Now, man, Bess started to drift. She hit the ship, but she just couldn't get a hand on it. She's racing Red Hills Bar. She had the deed to the ranch and a grand on it. With 8 grand going hot on the red line, she flew past a hitchhiker out on Route 39. He hollered, "Stand on it. Go ahead, baby, stand on it." When I went in doubt and you can't figure it out, just stand on it. Well, if your mind's confused, you don't know what you're gonna do, then buddy, stand on it. Well, if you've lost control of the situation at hand, grab a girl.
John Mason. John in his Rayburn chassis tonight. A car 100, the Universal Auto Repair 100 from Dick Barton in the 28, racing John Mason in 72. Bring the field around and the green is out. Into turn one they roll. Barton on the bottom, Mason up top. Side by side into turn two, it's racing John Mason down the back straightaway. Your leader, Dick Barton, second. Denny Chamberlain running third. Tim Hidden, car 68, moving on the inside to fourth. They jockey for positions off of turn four. One lap down. For some of these cars, it's probably the first time they've been on the speedway this year, so they've got some bugs to work out. Others have been out and been fast. Racing John Mason in car 72, you're your leader. Dick Barton starting to trail some smoke in car 28. He's running third now with Denny Chamberlain up to second. And Tim Hidden, car 68, on the move into third. Hidden to 68 now, third. Barton settles into fourth, running fifth to T8 of Mark Canal. The back straightaway to three, it's still John Mason. Battle for second now, Chamberlain to 31, Tim Hidden, car 68, really hooked up on the low side, coming off of turn four, side by side for second. Going into one, hit with that rocket chassis, drain-powered machine, taking over the second position. Running third, now Denny Chamberlain in car 31, but now the T8 still fourth, with Barton in the 28 fifth. Halfway, five laps are down, five down. John Mason, he leads by a straightaway in car 72. Mark Bedell on the T8 now on the move. Alongside of Denny Chamberlain, he'll make the pass going into three for third. Laps to go for John Mason. It's second, but now third. Chamberlain fourth, Park with that smoking 28 running fifth. Two remaining, eight laps down, two to go. Denny Chamberlain has just exploded the right rear tire, and Dick Barton making contact with him spins off the second turn in car 28. The yellow is out. Chamberlain losing the right rear tire in turn two, slowing in front of Dick Barton, who made slight contact before spinning to bring out the caution flag. A very wet racetrack, so quite a bit of changes to be made. Just two laps remaining when the green comes back out. John Mason in car 72, your leader. Tim Hidd has been the man on the move. He was quickly worked his way up to second, but nobody could get close to Mason before the caution. Let's see what happens now. It's Benal pressuring Hidd for second. Down the back straightaway, 1, 2, and 3, and now Barton into 28, moving up into 4th, getting around the 1P of Rodney Phillips, although Phillips comes right back at him on the inside through 4 and makes the pass. One lap to go, one lap remaining. Good battle for that 4th spot between Dick Barton and Rodney Phillips. Barton makes the pass in 1 and 2. Final lap. Racing John Mason out of Millersburg, Ohio, looking for the first checkered flag of 1993 at Pittsburgh's Pennsylvania Motor Speedway. It's second, but now third, Rodney Phillips fourth, and Dick Barton slows in car 28. He had been smoking most of the race. Problems for the 28 of Dick Barton. Hunter Repfab, number 84 from Fairmont, West Virginia, Steve Baker. Tony Bruno's 97 is a Barry Wright chassis. John Flynn. Tony Bruno, the 97. John Flinner in the D11. Pace the field for the start of our second Wolfshead late model heat race. Off the fourth turn they come, and the green is out. Flinner takes off with the lead. Johnny Johnson in car 48 is second. The battle of rocket chassis down the back straightaway. Tony Bruno, the 97, third. They're double fouls. They enter turn 3 in the middle of the pack. Out in front, Flinner, your leader. Stevie Baker making a high side move in turn 1. He started last. He's now third in car 84. Flinner leading in the 11-48. Johnny Johnson second, Steve Baker third, Brent Rayberg in the 07 fourth now. Battle for second. Steve Baker in car 84 on the low side makes the pass in turn 3 and 4. Johnson drops to third, Rayberg in fourth, Keith Zimmerman fifth in car T3. Phil O'Donnell trailing a lot of smoke in car 27. Phil O'Donnell in car 27 with a problem. Four laps down, 6 remaining. O'Donnell to the pits in car 27. The race for fourth now tightening up. Keith Zimmerman in the T3 alongside the 07 of Brent Rayberg. And makes the pass in turns 1 and 2. And out in front, it's Flinner, but closing in is Steve Baker. We still have 5 laps to go. Baker definitely closing in and closing in quick on John Flinner. Into 3. Flinner, your leader, but here comes Baker. 1 on the coal. 4 laps to go. Johnny Johnson in third. Keith Zimmerman fourth. Brent Rayberg in fifth. Winner's lead, now 5 car lengths. Less than that in turn 3. Baker up to the high side, coming off of 4. Watch the roll down the front chute. 3 to go. Stevie Baker in car 84 started last. He's trying to get the lead. Winner says no sirree down the back chute. We got a lap car in their path in turn 3. Tony Burke in the 09 may decide things here. Baker's on the brakes. He goes high. Flinner in the middle. It's still Flinner with 2 to go. Flinner, your leader. Baker up high into 1. Trying to get by Tony Burke, and he does. Running third, it's still Johnny Johnson in the 48, followed closely by the T3 of Keith Zimmerman. Just 1 lap to go. Flinner himself starting to trail some blue smoke in the D11. You can see it coming out from under the hood. John Flinner in the D11, but he hasn't slowed down. Steve Baker closed in, and then Flinner checked out. The D&T Automotive, Dave's Marina, H.E. Home & Concrete Contracting D11. John Flinner takes the win with Steve Baker second. Third, it's a Johnny Johnson with Keith Zimmerman fourth and Brent Raybergen fifth. John Flinner, your winner. Ending track champion in the Wolfshead late models. And in the RLE Chassis Center, Belich Excavating 48, moving up into the Wolfset Late Model Division. Said late model, set to go. 15, Nick Jones on the point. Bobby Burgess alongside into the fourth turn. They motor. Greg Wheeling, our flagman, looks them over. Doesn't like what he sees. The yellow is on. The yellow is on. We'll try him again. Everybody gets him slowed down in orderly fashion. Nick Jones in the 15, Bobby Burgess the 34, your front row again as we turn him loose off the fourth corner. Green is out. Into turn one. Ooh, close call there going into the corner. Jones your leader. Here comes Burgess on the outside. Side by side into three. Bobby Burgess takes the high side to the lead. Jones running second, Brian Ruhlman third, Bob Waring senior fourth, and Lynn Geisler fifth as they parade down the back chute. Ben Miley moves to sixth in car 99. Geisler this time to the high side through three and four, trying to work the outside of Bob Waring senior down the front straightaway. They roll. Into turn one, Lynn Geisler to fourth, trying to get third. Bobby Burgess looking quick in car 34, your leader. Body parts are flying away. Van Miley moves up to fifth in the 99. Miley now up to fourth. All of a sudden, Ben Miley has found the fast line from sixth to fourth in one lap. Way out ahead is Bobby Burgess in car 34. Here comes Miley. He's hugging the rail. Side by side with Brian Ruhlman for third as they enter the first turn. Miley makes that pass. He now has second as Jones pushes high in the 15. And Brian Ruhlman in the 49 moves to third. Lynn Geisler has slowed down considerably. The 1C is off the pace. Yellow flag is out. We've got some debris on the speedway in turn three. And Bobby Burgess's lead is evaporated. Bob Waring Sr. in the 1. Rick Dawson is 10 and Ben Belich in the 48. Burgess brings him into turn 4. He's your leader as they exit the 4th turn down the front straightaway. Bobby Burgess still leading, but Ben Miley applies plenty of pressure in turn 2 down the back straightaway. Burgess able to open up some daylight going into 3. He goes in hard. Miley sticking to his tail off of turn 4. 4 laps to go. Waring up to third now in the 1. Ruhlman in the 49 running 4th. Jones in the 15, 5th. Bobby Burgess looking tough in car 34 off the 4th turn. Here comes Miley to the inside. Can't get the move made. 2.5 laps remaining. Bobby Burgess by a car length, your leader. Off the 4th turn. Here comes Miley to the low side another time. 2 to go. Waring running 3rd. Ruhlman 4th and Rick Dawson. Now look out. Nick Jones spinning on the front straightaway in the 15 into the heavy tires. Yellow is out. Nick Jones in the 15. Losing it here, coming off the 4th turn, spinning. Each feature will receive a case of oil. We'll tell you more about that in a moment. The green is back out with 2 laps to go. Bobby Burgess in the 34, Ben Miley in the 99, coming off of turn 4, it's still Burgess. Miley 2nd, Waring 3rd, Ruhlman 4th, and Rick Dawson is 5th. Miley right on Bobby Burgess's tail off the 2nd turn, down the back straightaway into turn 3. Here comes Bob Waring Sr. in the 1, challenging Miley now for 2nd. They stack him up off the 4th turn. The white flag is waving. And Miley moves to the inside, but again, Burgess with enough straightaway speed to hold him off. Final lap, Bobby Burgess in the SB machine. Number 34, your leader, and looking strong. Ben Miley and Bob Waring Sr., a whole lot of feature wins on his tail off the 4th turn. Your winner is Bobby Burgess. Miley 2nd, Waring 3rd, Ruhlman 4th, and Rick Dawson 5th. An impressive win for young Bobby Burgess. Picked up some feature wins a year ago up at the Windber Speedway. Getting Jook George's number 10, brand new color scheme. Boy, he's been a blue number 10 for a long time this year, red and white. Off the fourth turn, they get to the cone, they go, the green is out. Mike Johnson's 1J, that's a bullet chassis, he's your leader. Bill Yakin in the 10, also a bullet car running second. Ricky Thomas has a rocket car. He's in third. Pressure, though, by the three of Richie Curry. Look out. Richie's is a bullet, the number three. Gary Lyles. We got a big chunk of debris bouncing on the inside of the front straightaway there. Curry into three on the outside, trying to make the pass of Ricky Thomas as they exit turn four down the front straightaway into turn one. Ricky Thomas at the 99, Rich Curry into three, side by side for third, like there's no tomorrow as they enter turn three. Curry makes the pass, now trying to take second from Bill Yakin. Three laps down, Mike Johnson out in front. And here goes Richie Curry on the high side to second. Yakin in the 10 drops into third. Thomas the 99 fourth. Gary Lyle in the 10. The black 10 running fifth. Then it's Ed Dunn in car 41. Richie Curry closing in on Mike Johnson. Halfway this time by, we'll have five more laps to go. Curry really quick through the corners into three. He's running a higher line than the other drivers. Here he goes. He's alongside of Mike Johnson almost as they exit the second turn. Behind them, a side-by-side race for third and fourth. Ricky Thomas and Bill Yakin off the fourth turn down the front straightaway. Mike Johnson and Rich Curry into turn number one. Johnson down low, Curry up high. Down the back straightaway. Still too close to call. Good racing action in the limited late model division. Curry gets a little too high this time, and Johnson maintains the lead. Curry second. Three to go. Ricky Thomas is third. Bill Yakin fourth. Gary Lyle fifth. Look how quickly, though, Curry closes in again. Through the corners. He's got it set up well. The number three car really rolling. Two laps to go. Two to go. Side by side for the lead off the fourth turn. White flag waving. Who's it going to be? One lap to go. Oh, Mike Johnson. Mike Johnson starting to blow smoke into 1J. Curry, your leader in car three. Johnson may have some engine problems. The Pitmon Auto, number three out of Pittsburgh, taking the limited late model heat race win, Richie Curry. Close for second. Still Mike Johnson able to get second in the 1J by inches. Ricky Thomas in the 99 third. From Dravosburg, Russ Kolesar. In the Vint Burgess in the 26. Tony Storm the 44 bring the field. Of course, we've got the cone back. When they get to the cone, we go. And they're off. Oh, no, don't stop there, Jim. Jim was slowing down. Everybody was going. A Chinese fire drill on the front straightaway. The fourth turn again. This time the green is out. Jimmy Burgess in car 26 takes off with the early lead. Russ Kolesar in the 8 in second. Doug Crawford's 9 third. Larry Kugel charges to fourth in car 14. Brian Meyer quickly slows into 21. Now it looks like he's back underway. Tony Storm in the pits in the 44. Jimmy Burgess hooked up in car 26. Russ Colasar looking real good in the number 8. He's been picking up some experience. Russell looks like he's really picked it up from a year ago. Doug Crawford in the 9 also looking strong in that bullet chassis. He's third. It's going to be a top division in 93, the limited late models, no doubt about it. Larry Kugel's 14 in fourth. Rick Armstrong 29 fifth, and it's Ron Myers to 21. Limited late models are going to be very, very competitive. And there's many that aren't completed yet that'll be out soon. Halfway, 5 laps down and 5 to go. Finish, 2 to go. Jimmy Burgess still shows the way, car 26. Russ Colasar in the 8th second. Doug Crawford's 9 third. Larry Kugel in the 14 fourth, and Rick Armstrong's 29 fifth. White flag waving this time, 1 lap to go. Checkered flag for Jim Burgess in the Shop and Save Century 3, Baltimore House, Antino's Restaurant 26. Second to Russ Colasar. That's got to be his best finish ever here at Pittsburgh. Doug Crawford in the 9 seat third. Larry Kugel in the 14 is fourth. Rick Armstrong in the 29 and Ron Myers in the 21 round out the field. Is out. Mark Zickenhuis, he was awfully quick here a year ago in the 26. He's your early leader. Jack Crescent in 5 running second. Jim Dandy Jr. in the 19 is third. Rusty Jones in the 2. Kurt Habedell in the 75 are close behind. Up high in turn 4, Jack Crescent of 5 closes in. Jim Dandy Jr. the 19 third. Kurt Habedell in the 75 fourth. Rusty Jones in the 2 cars fifth. Jim Dandy Jr. in the 19. Jim Dandy Jr. off the pace in car 19. right away. You want to know how fast these guys are turning. Mark Ziegfeld turned that last lap at about 21.8 seconds is what we had the last lap for Mark Ziegfeld. They're getting around there pretty good. The ump modifieds. Two cars in the pits, 16, Darren Miller, along with the 19 of Jim Dandy Jr. Whoa, contact on the front straightaway. Paul Busch in the 42, Bernie Potanowicz in the 36. They get things sorted out. Ziegfeld still your leader. Two laps remaining, two to go. Jack Kress in second, Kurt Habedale in the 75, the Kodak-sponsored 75 is third. Rusty Jones in the 2 fourth, that's Paul Busch in the 42, and the 36 of Bernie Potanowicz. One lap remaining. Checkered flag in the Red Line Motorsports 26, Mark Ziegfeld from Conneaut Lake. Jack Kress second. Kurt Habedale from Imperial in the 75 car third. And we got one off the pace here, the yellow and the checkered now. Green is out. First of two spectator stock heats. Rick Walker in the 93X is your leader. Bob Hine in the 92 car running second. Don Briggs in the 18 third, but it's early as they charge down the back chute. Pete Lorre in the 11, who started last, moved to fifth there. Rick Walker shows the way with one lap down. Pete Lorre in the 11 on the high side in turn one takes over third. The 93X, Rick Walker, Bob Hine looking good in the 92. He's second. Pete Lorre has started last, already the third in car number 11. Don Briggs in the 18 and Jesse Exler in the 22E racing for fourth and fifth. Things are getting crowded out in front. Still Rick Walker, but no room for air. Bob Hine, the 92. He gets high in the second turn, and here comes the 11 of Pete Lorre underneath him. He'll take up the chase on Rick Walker as we approach the halfway point. Four more laps to go. Pete Lorre looking to come from last to first in the 11. Really on the charge. Goes to the inside in turn four. Off the turn, Lorre has got the fast lane. He's your new leader. Pete Lorre. Car number 11 brings him by. Two laps to go. Pete finished eighth in the point standings a year ago in the number 11. Rick Walker in the 93X was our third place points finisher last season. He runs second. Bob Hine looking good here to begin the season in the 92 and third. And Jesse Exler also looking much improved in the 22. He runs fourth. final lap. Jim Zarin, who had a strong ride a year ago in the 1C with some definite problems here in the first night. He's well off the pace. He comes off the fourth turn, running tail to field. Checkered flag in the Tony Dale BP number 11. Pete Loria takes the win. Rick Walker second. Third of the 92 of Bob Hine. Jesse Exler with a problem here. Got a flat tire in the 22E, trying to get it home fourth. Hurry up, Jesse. They're coming after you. He makes it. And for you Mike Johnson fans, motor problems will keep our defender any closer. Off they go. Toronto Patchen certainly hasn't slowed down over the winter. He's your leader. John Ponikvar second in the 16 with Andy Katselis in the 64, a close third. He may get second as they exit the fourth turn. Katselis in the 64 takes over the runner-up spot. Opatchen leading. Look at Katselis close in down the back straightaway within a car length entering turn three. Alongside in four. And he has the lead coming off of turn four. Textbook pass by Andy Katselis. Ron Opatchen says, hold on, Andy, I'm coming back at you. He challenges on the inside down the front straightaway, but Katselis holds him off. Katselis, your leader at the halfway point. Four down, four to go. Fourth and fifth, bunched up pretty good here. John Ponikvar in the 16, Jeff Bronaszewski in the 10, and wee Willie White in the 55. Two remaining, two laps to go. Said late models moving into the staging area. Jeff Bronaszewski in the 10 now moving to third. Get around the 16 of John Ponikvar. The tow mine's towing number 10. The Drew's Auto Service 64 of Andy Katselis, your leader. Sunrise Motors 51 of Ron Opatchen in the runner-up spot. Checkered flag is waving for Andy Katselis. Ron Opatchen is second. Jeff Bronaszewski third, and coming home fourth. Who will it be? Wee Willie White, fourth in the 55. John Ponikvar in the 16, fifth. Well, that'll wrap up the heat races for tonight. The Wolfshead Late Model 25 lap features up next. Quick chance for you to stretch your legs in the field tonight after dropping out of his heat in the number one Cochran, Balea Oil, 1C from Evans City, Lynn Geisler, and the Auction Barn, Farney Fabrication, 09 from Sarbert, Sony Burke. John John Mason in the 72. John Flinner in the 11. Bring the field into turn 4. The green is out and they're underway. 25 Fast and Furious last. The Wolf and late model. Earn them loose. Down the back straightaway to 3. Mason, your early leader. Running second is Flinner. Side by side for third, Burgess and Baker with them. Hit on the inside in car 68. Race and John Mason opening up some daylight early on here with Flinner second, Burgess third, hit fourth, Baker fifth, Miley runs sixth, Finale seventh. Then it's Johnny Johnson eighth, Bob Waring ninth, Keith Zimmerman tenth. Mason's lead already almost a full straightaway. Contact between Hit and Burgess. Just slight contact on the back straightaway. As Hit gets by, he was the third in the 68. Burgess in the 34 is fourth. Stevie Baker in the 84 running fifth. Mark Bunnell's up to sixth in car C8. Miley in the 99 seventh. Johnny Johnson eighth, Waring ninth. Brian Roman runs 10th. Four laps down, race and John Mason, your leader. Mark Bunnell, the T8, moving the car into fourth. Or fifth, excuse me. Bunnell, the T8 is now fifth. Jim Hidden, car 68, continues to pressure John Flinner for second. There in turn three. Race and John Mason about to enter lap traffic with five laps down. Here comes Timmy Hidden, trying to take second from John Flinner into turn number one. Hitting car 68 has the second spot. Winner drops to third, Burgess fourth. But now running fifth, Miley sixth. Baker seventh. Johnny Johnson eighth. Waring ninth, Brian Roman tenth. John Mason working lap traffic around the 97 of Tony Bruno down the back straightaway. Six laps down. Mason off the fourth turn, behind the 15 of Nick Jones. Tim Hitt now second in the 68, and pulling away from the 11 of John Flinner, who runs in third. Bobby Burgess still fourth. Mark Bunnell fifth. Ben Miley is now sixth in car 99. Ben Bellich off the pace in car 48. Ben Bellich slowing down the back straightaway. He will make it into the pits in car 48. Green stays out. Eight laps are down. Racing John Mason, leading by a full straightaway, and that's C.J. Rayburn, number 72, like he's on a rail with a Malcuit engine. Timmy Hitt out of the box with a new rocket chassis. He runs second. John Flinner has his hands full in third in the D11. Mark Bunnell, the T8, uses lap traffic to his advantage to move around Bobby Burgess and up into fourth. Burgess in the 34 is fifth now. Miley in the 99 runs sixth. Baker seventh. Johnny Johnson eighth. Brian Roman ninth. Bob Waring senior tenth. Lynn Geisler, who started last, is now 11th. Oh, we got contact on the front straightaway. Johnny Johnson in the 48 spins, and we got contact with T3, Keith Zimmerman. And John Mason. John Mason makes contact with Rodney Phillips as the yellow had thrown. The yellow had waved. John Mason making contact with Rodney Phillips coming down the front straightaway here. Timmy hit a brand new rocket chassis out of the Mark Richards Racing Shops with a Dream engine under the hood. Ten laps down, 15 remaining. Tim Hitt, car 68, your leader. They're chomping at the bit. The green is out. Off the fourth turn, Mark Bunnell gets a flying start in the T8, trying to move to second, and he does. Tim Hitt leading, Bunnell second. still third, Burgess fourth, Miley is fifth. And moving into contention, in the 1C, Lynn Geisler, who started this race last. Now running seventh is Lynn Geisler. Tim Hippel looking strong. As we approach the halfway point. Halfway, when they come by, Tim Hitt always has impressed me as a driver, and he certainly isn't doing anything to change that tonight. 12 laps remaining at the halfway point of our opening. We'll set late model feature event of 93. Now second, Twitter third, Burgess fourth, Miley fifth, Baker sixth, Brian Ruhlman now has moved into seventh in car 49, and Geisler, the 1C, drops back to eighth. Running ninth, Nick Jones, Mike Wilson, the 110. The track is taking its toll on some of the bodies. 10 laps to go, 10 to go. Now comes upon the 09 of Tony Burke. Look out, Burke crosses in front of him as it comes down the front straightaway. Hit. What a close call in turn one. He gets by. But now still second. Oh, crash off the fourth turn. Look out, here comes our leader. Timmy Hitt gets it slowed down in time. The yellow is out. Brett Rehberger in the 07 gets sideways in front of the 48 of Ben Belich. Another hard crash. A lot of damage. Nine laps to the finish. The lights are out. Timmy Hitt brings the field around to the green flag. It's out another time. But now the T8 right behind him in second. Flinter and Burgess go high. Ben Miley in the 99 trying to take third. Into one. Some real ill. Miley gets turned sideways in the 99. Geisler spins. And the yellow is out. Ben Miley and Lynn Geisler come to a stop over in turn two.
Steam coming out, some overheating problems. Probably right, the warmest place in the speedway. Unfortunately, that's not a good sign.
Green is back out, and there goes Timmy Hitt with the lead another time. John Flinter races Mark Bunnell hard into turn one for second. Bunnell holds him off. Flinter third, Burgess fourth. Look out. Roman's tight. Here comes Stevie Baker on the high side. They are driving wild here tonight. Burgess with a problem in the 34. Yellow is out. Bobby Burgess may have got a little tap in the left rear in one and two. It may have kind of tired out or something, but Timmy Hitt takes off the green drops. Underway another time at Dirt's Monster Half Mile. The Woolshed Late Models with eight laps to the finish. John Flinter and Stevie Baker wheel to wheel for third down the back straightaway. Geisler up to fifth now in the 1C. Flinter and Baker really battling. Flinter third, Baker fourth. Geisler is fifth and closing on Baker down the front chute. Laps now down. Lynn Geisler and Stevie Baker wheel to wheel. For fourth, Geisler makes the pass going into one. We got a car sitting in turn three. Car sitting against the guardrail. The yellow flag is out. car sitting against the guardrail in turn three. And away we go. Six laps to the finish. Tim Hit this time doesn't go as early as he did the last. Bunnell trying to outsmart him on the restart, but it's Hit, your leader. Mark Bunnell awfully close. In fact, pushing him off the fourth turn. Lynn Geisler on the outside. Down the back straightaway. Geisler from last to first. Hit with a problem in car 68. Tim Hit is off the pace in car 68. Lynn Geisler, your leader, with five laps to go. Yellow is out for Tim Hit in car 68. Another new leader. And when he goes, the green drops. Flinter third. Ben Miley's back to fourth in the 99. Steve Baker runs fifth in car 84. Mark Bunnell trying to get the start, but it won't go, because Lynn Geisler is the leader, and he will start the race. Lynn Geisler will start the race, even though he's elected to start outside. And now we go into three and four, side by side. Contact out in front. Geisler continues, but Al's into the guardrail. The green is out. I tell you what, we've seen enough in this one to last us a year. There's been more thrills and spills in the opening feature event. The question is, did Lynn Geisler suffer a flat tire? He took a hard hit in the left rear. Four laps to go. Will the tires stay up? He's your leader. Miley second. Flinter third. Baker fourth. Mike Blose is fifth in car 100. Mike Blose now fifth in car 100. Three laps to go. Ben Miley trying to close in on Lynn Geisler off the fourth turn. They roll two to go. Winner still third, Baker fourth. Mark Bunnell now pressuring Mike Blose for fifth. Geisler's lead about five car lengths going into turn three. And here comes Miley closing ground. We've got one lap to go. One to go. In turn number one and two, Miley again closing in. Down the back straightaway, it's Lynn Geisler, our Wolfset late model track champion from a year ago. Trying to pick up where he left off. And the number one Cochran, Belay Oil 1C, from last to first, Lynn Geisler. Then Miley second, John Flinter third, Steve Baker fourth, and Mark Bunnell fifth. Started in the 22nd position. He finished first. He was our leading. And tonight, he picks up a case of oil from Monarch Oil and Wolf's Head for being our hard charger. And also, that's $200 to Chuck Ward and his family, $50 from Lynn Geisler, $50 from number one Cochran, $50 from Lernerville Speedway, and $50 from Pittsburgh's Pennsylvania Motor Speedway. Every time Lynn Geisler wins a feature here in 1993. On the pole in car 14 is Larry Kosar. Outside the 26 of Jimmy Burgess from Allison Park. Then it's Richie Curry in car 3 from Pittsburgh, and Gary Lau from Hyde Park in the 10. From Bloomingdale, Ohio, the 29 of Rick Arnold. Feature events for the limited late models. Defending track champ Mike Johnson not able to make the field with engine problems. Larry Kugel had the early lead, but there goes Bill Yakin. The Yakin in the 10-year leader. Kugel in the 14 second. Ricky Thomas in the 99 is third. Zach Crawford in the 9 seed fourth. Jimmy Burgess in the 26 runs fifth. Jerks Body Shop, Fox Machine 10 of Bill Yakin on the move. Tony Storm to the pits in car 44. Larry Kugel still second, Ricky Thomas third, Doug Crawford fourth. Jimmy Burgess fifth. The man on the move is the three of Rich Curry. He's running the high side of the racetrack. On the cushion, he and Jimmy Burgess side by side for fifth. Don't forget, Monarch Oil, Western Pennsylvania's largest distributor of Wolfset and Wolfset Oil, sponsoring our Hard Charger Award in this feature event as well. Curry is now fifth in car three. Bill Yakin, your leader. We're a quarter of the way through this time by. Five laps will be down. Five down, 15 to go. Curry gets up high into three that time, and Burgess to the 26 reclaims the fifth spot. But Curry right back around him going into turn one. But again, he's high in two. Out of the racing groove, has to back out of it. Jimmy Burgess in car 26 now underneath Doug Crawford in the 9 as they race hard for 4th going into 1. Oh, some contact. Burgess, Crawford, and Curry awfully tight in turn 1 and 2. Down the back straightaway. Racing for 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th. Crowded. Three laps to the halfway point. Now two laps as Billy Yakin comes by in car 10. Completing lap number 8. Two laps to the halfway point. Larry Kugel still second with Ricky Thomas third, Jim Burgess fourth, and Rich Curry fifth. Continues to pull away in car 10. Larry Kugel still second. Ricky Thomas third. Jim Burgess fourth. Rich Curry fifth. Russ Colasar running a strong 6th in the 8th. And it's Doug Crawford and Gary Lyle. Ed Dunn and Ricky Armstrong trail the field. Straightaway, the battle though for second, third, and fourth. Pretty good race between Larry Kugel's 14, Ricky Thomas in the 99, and Jim Burgess in the 26. Richard Curry in the 3 running a close 5th. Then it's Russ Colasar in the 8th, Doug Crawford in the 9, and Gary Lyle in the 10, all still on the lead lap. laps to go. Look at this battle for second, third, fourth, and fifth. Thomas gets high in the 99. He goes from third to fifth. Again, second, third, and fourth, tight off the fourth turn. With Bill Yankins all by himself, but behind him, there's a heck of a race going on. Kugel, Burgess, and Curry off the fourth turn another time. Coming around for the white flag in the Jukes Body Shop, Cox Machine 10. Contact in turn one and two. Kugel goes spinning in the 14. Oh, down the back straightaway. Doug Crawford able to get slowed down just in time. Larry Kugel in car 14, ending up on the wrong end of the stick that time in turn two. Oh. Richie Curry to the high side of Ricky Thomas in that battle for second. Oh, there's some contact for second. They're hooked. They separate. Down the front straightaway they roll. Two laps to go. Curry slows a bit in one and two. Down the back straightaway, he's off the pace in the number three. Coming for the white flag, one lap to go. It's Bill Yakin leading. Ricky Thomas second, Russ Kolasar third. Larry Kugel is back up to fourth, and Doug Crawford runs fifth. Rich Curry slowing down the front straightaway. Strong run. About to come to an end. Checkered flag out in the Jukes Body Shop, Cox Machine 10. Bill Yakin, your winner. Second to Ricky Thomas. Russ Kolasar has his best finish in his young career. Third, Larry Kugel in the 14th. Fourth, and Doug Crawford's nine completes the top five. Bill Yakin teams up with the ump modified. We had a four-way tie for the hard charge in the limited late model division. Pushing the 42, Bernie Botanowicz 36, and the white 19 is Jim Dandy Jr., and we're still waiting. The fourth turn, it's Jack Crusher leader with Mark Zickerfoo second, Kurt Habedell in third, Bernie Botanowicz fourth, and Paul Busch fifth. 15-lap feature event. Bumper to bumper for the lead, Jack Kress and Mark Zickerfoo. Oh, Zickerfoo is sideways into the guardrail. Car spinning behind him, and Paul Busch hard into the outside wall. Yellow flag comes out. Mark Zickerfuss in the 26 got her sideways, and I didn't see what happened behind him, but there was some contact as Paul Busch in the 42 shot straight into the outside. Team laps to go. Jack Crest, still your leader, bro. Ernie Patano working the 32nd. Jim Dandy Jr. Now, Jim Dandy Jr. was a pure stock runner the past couple of years up at the Sharon Speedway and also at the Hickory Speedway. In fact, was the track champion. Rusty Jones with a flat tire and a two. Jack Kress continues to lead. Well, the field has been diminished, but there's a good race for the lead. Jack Kress in the 5, Jim Dandy Jr. in the 19, and Bernie Patanowick in the 36. Pass, maybe a pass for the lead. Jim Dandy Jr., 19, trying hard on the inside. Close. Jack Kress in the 5. Now Jim Dandy Jr. to the outside. Took a look at it anyway in turn 3. Got to wind up on the outside again going into 1. Settles behind the 5 of Jack Kress down the back straight away. This is the halfway point this time by. There goes Jim Dandy hard into turn 3. Jim Dandy makes a dandy of a pass for the lead. 7 laps to go. Jim Dandy Jr. in his maiden voyage in the unmodifieds, looking for that checkered flag. Jack Kress in the 5 second, Bernie Patanowicz 36 third. Rusty Jones returns to action in car 2. Five laps to go. You know, NASCAR, they have a 55-mile-an-hour speed limit in the pits. Rusty thought there was a 55-mile-an-hour speed limit on the racetrack as he got a little slow start coming off the first turn. But he's back up to speed in the 2. Having some problems, though. Something's not all together right in the number 2 car. 4 laps remaining. Several laps down. And three laps to go. Laps to go. Jim Dandy Jr. out of Niles, Ohio. A Buckeye. Takes the white flag, 1 lap to go. Last year was a pure stock champion up at the Hickory Speedway, Sharon Speedway strong runner. Now he's in the unmodifieds, and he takes the opening win of 93 here at Pittsburgh. Jim Dandy Jr., Jack Kress second. And the 36 of Bernie Pacanowicz is the third car finishing on the lead lap. Then it's the 10 of Jeff Bronoszewski, the 92 of Bob Hine, 51 Ronald Patchen, Rick Wachter, 93X, Sandy Catellus in the 64, Pete Lurie in the 11, Jim Stevens in the 38, John Ponikbar in the 16, Don Briggs in the 18, and Jim Zarin in the 1C. Those are your field.
That is your field.
That is your field. 15 lap feature event. Your leader. Jim Dandy, by the way, was also our umpire, hard charger. So he gets a case of Wolf's Head Oil from Wolf's Head and Monarch Oil for being the ump hard charger in addition to his feature win. Wee Willie White is your early leader here in car 55. Jeff Bronoszewski in the 10 is on the move, running a strong second. Jesse Exler's 22 third. Rick Walker, 93X, fourth. Don Briggs in car 18 slows on the back straightaway. Two laps in the books. Don Briggs trying to get the 18 to the pits. He makes it. Jeff Bronoszewski in the 10, challenging Wee Willie White on the inside for the lead. Still Wee Willie showing the way. Jesse Exler a little out of shape in the 22E, back in the pack. Still Wee Willie White in the 55, Jeff Bronoszewski on his tail in the 10. Rick Walker's 93X third, Bob Hine 92 fourth, Pete Lurie in the 11 running fifth. Jeff Bronoszewski slingshots to the inside going into turn one. Wee Willie's got the groove. Here comes Bronoszewski putting the hammer down. Down the back straightaway in the 10, takes the lead. From McKee's Rocks in the tow mine towing 10, Jeff Bronoszewski. 10 laps to go. Andy Cattell is starting to work up into contention. He gets around the 51 of Ronald Patchen, is now in the sixth spot in the 64. He was awfully fast in his heat race. Ellis in the 64 moves into fifth. Jeff Bronoszewski pulling away in number 10. Last year, Jeff Bronoszewski had three feature wins. Finished second in the points to champion Ronald Patchen, missing out by 1 point on the tie for the track title. second, third, fourth, and fifth are bumper to bumper into turn three. Wee Willie White in the 55, Rick Walker 93, Pete Lurie in the 11, and Andy Catellus in the 64, who goes for a spin. Catellus spins into the guardrail on the inside of the fourth turn. Yellow is out, 10 laps down. Green is out, 5 to go. And they're scattering for positions. Bronicheski leads. In the 11, going for a second in turn three, makes the pass. Can he hang on? Up a little high. Laps to go, 2 to go. Andy Catellus, a little air conditioning tonight in the 64. White flag, this time by for Jeff Bronicheski. One lap to go. No Mind Towing, number 10, out of a Keys Rocks. Jeff Bronicheski off the fourth turn takes the opening feature event for the Spectator Stocks in 93. Pete Lurie a second, Wee Willie White third, Rick Walker fourth, and Ron Patchen fifth. Jeff Bronicheski. Looks like he too will be a tough one.